In this tutorial, you will get to know how to configure your QUINT DC UPS in PLCnext Engineer. In a first step, please download the PLCnext library file on phoenixcontact.com. After downloading, you will get a compressed file. You will find the library file and the corresponding help documents in the compressed package. Import the library file in the PLCnext project. Open PLCnext Engineer and select the CPU you are using to quickly create a new project. Click right on the library directory and select Add User Library. Select the PCWLX library file, which you just downloaded, and open it. Then you will see the UPS library in the library catalog. In the programming catalog, you will find the corresponding data type and three function blocks. In the network catalog, you will find the UPS devices list. Configuration of the IP address. After importing the hardware library, we come to the software settings. Therefore, please double-click the project label and set the correct IP range. Afterwards, set the IP address assignment mode of your PLC to manual and enter the IP address. Double-click the project label again and enter the online device window. Select the network adapter you are using and click Scan Network. Find and click the PLC device that matches to your PLC's MAC address in the scan results. Set the UPS IP address and device name. Select the UPS in use and its peripheral equipment from the equipment catalog. Drag them into the PROFINET branch of the project. Enter the UPS setting window and set the UPS IP address and device name. Then enter the online device window of PROFINET and assign the set IP address and device name to the online UPS. Software and hardware settings are completed now. Now, we download the project to the PLC to connect it with the UPS. Usage of function blocks to read cyclical data of the UPS. Now, we will explain how to use the function block in the user library to read the cyclical data of the UPS. In a first step, leave the debug mode. Then create a main program. Drag the cyclic one function block into the workspace. create variables for all input and output of the function block. It should be noted that the input array, input process data, needs to be a global variable. Continue to create other variables. Afterwards, please check if the variable types of the created variables are correct. Connect the UPS process data with the global variables. Download the project to the PLC again. Open the online monitoring window of the program at the ESM label. Activate the function block. Put the data you want to monitor into the watch table. The structure variable UDT data struct contains all UPS cyclic data. The variable can also be displayed as a decimal number. Usage of function blocks to read alarm information of UPS. In the next step, we will explain how to use the function block in the user library to read the alarm information of the UPS. In a first step, please drag the DIAG function block into the workspace. Then assign a variable to all inputs and outputs. Check again that the correct type has been assigned to all created variables. Now we download the program into the PLC. Activate the function block. Add the output alarm information into the watch list. Disconnect the communication cable between the battery and the UPS. You will see that the alarm information is displayed in the list and the output diagnostics alarm is set to 1. Now we will explain how to use the function block param to read or send parameters. Again, create new variables for all the inputs, outputs, and inouts. Download the project into the PLC. At first, we need to get to know the node ID of the UPS in slot 1. In the submodule list window of slot 1, you will find the node ID of the devices. Index 16 hashtag 20OD indicates the temperature of the battery in Kelvin. The length of the parameter is 2 bytes. Activate the function block. Then enable the input parameter xReceive. Now add the receiver buffer variable into the watch list. In the first 2 bytes, we will see the temperature of the battery is 33 degrees.